and gentlemen, this memento is something to feast your eyes on, and we will let you have a look at it if our gathering could just come in here. Thank you so much. Can we have the memento projected on screen, please? All right, here it is. This very exquisite etching has been designed by none other than Nandita Puri. And the photograph, the logo here, I'm not sure whether you can see it very clearly, but that is the photograph. That was clicked by the London-based photographer Vipul Sangoi. So this is it. Nice, rough cut, as rough as Om Puri ji. Absolutely. Of course, this is the wonderful book written by Nandita Puri, very aptly titled Unlikely Hero.
That's my favorite book and my favorite author, so I won't miss out on this picture. I would like to join you.
एक तो मैं समझती हूँ इट्स एन ऑनर एंड अ प्रिविलेज के जो फर्स्ट मेमोरियल लेक्चर है आज श्याम बेनेगल जी के बाद गोविंद निहलानी जी के बाद मैं इधर पहला लेक्चर देने वाली हूँ ऑन द फर्स्ट फाउंडेशन ईयर एंड मेरे लिए बहुत ही बड़ा ऑनर है क्योंकि ओम जी वॉज अ लार्जर देन लाइफ एक्सप्लोजिव टैलेंट दैट इंडिया हैड मेरे हिसाब से दे वेंट टू सून ही वेंट टू सून एंड इट इज समथिंग दैट इज यू नो इरिप्लेसेबल लॉस टू द फिल्म इंडस्ट्री तो जैसे कि मैंने कहा मेरे लिए बहुत बड़ा ऑनर है एंड मैं समझती हूँ नंदिता जी भी बहुत ही अच्छा काम कर रही हैं आप देखेंगे आगे स्कॉलरशिप्स दिए जा रहे हैं एंड सर्टिफिकेट्स दिए जा रहे हैं टू पीपल हु रियली नीड सो द फाउंडेशन इज डूइंग लॉट ऑफ गुड वर्क एंड जैसे कि मैंने कहा इट्स अ वेरी बिग ऑनर फॉर मी टू बी हियर टू यू नो ऑन दिस सॉलेम ओकेजन वेयर द फर्स्ट ईयर ऑफ द ओम पुरी फाउंडेशन हैज जस्ट टेकन बर्थ तो मैंने बोल दिया ना इरिप्लेसेबल लॉस
ओके तो उमेश सर ने काफी इंटरनेशनल फिल्म्स की है हॉलीवुड में जाके तो कितना इंडियन फिल्म इंडस्ट्री को उन्होंने आगे तक बढ़ाया
आई थिंक इंडियन फिल्म इंडस्ट्री को इंडिया में भी और पूरे देश पूरे यू नो लिटरली ऑन द होल प्लैनेट ऑन द ग्लोब ही पुट इंडिया ऑन द ग्लोब विथ हिज टैलेंट एंड दैट इज अ वेरी बिग थिंग क्योंकि जब ओम पुरी जी वगैरह हॉलीवुड जाते थे यहाँ तो ऐसे लगता था कि कोई चांस ही नहीं कि हमारे एक्टर्स भी इंटरनेशनल फिल्म्स करेंगे एंड ही मेड द ब्रेक थ्रू फर्स्ट विच आई थिंक वॉज प्योरली ऑन हिज टैलेंट क्योंकि उन तरीके का लेजेंड और जिस लेवल ऑफ उनकी जो कला थी आई थिंक कोई मैच नहीं कर सकता न कर पाएगा अकॉर्डिंग टू मी
आपको याद है आपका फर्स्ट इंटरेक्शन विद ओम पुरी सर
जी हाँ बिल्कुल मैंने तीन फिल्में की उनके साथ एक फिल्म थी आन एक फिल्म थी विनाशक और शायद और भी की होंगी जो भी एकदम फिलहाल याद नहीं लेकिन मुझे याद है मेरा जो पहला सीन था वो मैं बहुत नर्वस थी क्योंकि यू नो उस समय मैं नई सी थी एंड यू नो जस्ट सॉर्ट ऑफ मेकिंग माई मार्क इन द इंडस्ट्री और मुझे मौका मिल रहा था यू नो ओम पुरी जी के साथ काम करने का तो जो पहला सीन था तो उनको उन्होंने शायद पहचान लिया कि मैं थोड़ी नर्वस हूँ उनके साथ डायलॉगबाजी करने में ये वो तो मेरे पास आई बोली क्या नर्वस हो गया तो मैंने कहा हाँ थोड़ा सा मतलब मेरा इतना लंबा डायलॉग है और आप खड़े हैं सामने तो आपके सामने परफॉर्म करना तो बहुत बड़ी बात है बोला रे वो सब भूल जाओ चलो मैं तुमको जोक सुनाता हूँ एंड उन्होंने स्टार्ट किया अपने जोक सुनाना और उनका सेंस ऑफ ह्यूमर इतना अच्छा था कि वो हंसा हंसा के ना यूज टू मेक द अदर पर्सन कंफर्टेबल तो उनमें वो बड़प्पन था जो काफ़ी बड़े बड़े सुपरस्टार्स में नहीं है वो समझते हैं उनकी ही परफॉर्मेंस सबसे बेस्ट होनी चाहिए तो दूसरी की परफॉर्मेंस खराब कर दो काफ़ी लोग ऐसा करते हैं लेकिन ओम पुरी जी का कहना यह था कि अगर तुम अच्छा परफॉर्मेंस दोगी तो मैं भी अच्छा परफॉर्म करूँगा और हमें एक सीन यानी कि एक फिल्म को उठाना है तो उनमें वो इतना बड़प्पन था यू नो विच आई थिंक इज ब्यूटिफुल
ऐसी कोई चीज आपने
आई थिंक आई हैव टू गो फॉर द थिंग
ओके
या फास्ट
लास्ट क्वेश्चन ओके सो आप अपने कॉलेज में आए हो इतने साल बाद तो जैसे कि आपने कहा क्या कुछ चेंजेस
बहुत ही ऐसे लगता है मैं किसी फ्यूचरिस्टिक यू नो साइंस फिक्शन मूवी देख रही हूँ इतना पूरा चेंज हो गया इट्स लाइक अ फाइव स्टार होटल आज के बच्चे इतने लकी हैं कि उनको ऐसे कैंपसेस और ऐसे यू नो चांस मिल रहा है इस तरीके के कॉलेजेस में पढ़ने का आई थिंक इट्स फैंटास्टिक थैंक यू सो मच थैंक यू
थैंक यू अनंत जी फॉर सच अ काइंड इंट्रोडक्शन बिग नमस्कार टू ऑल लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन स्टूडेंट्स हु आर प्रेजेंट हियर दिस आफ्टरनून विद अस ऑन दिस ब्यूटिफुल ओकेजन बिग नमस्कार एंड प्रणाम टू ऑल माई सीनियर्स It was so wonderful to hear Shyamji speak, then to hear Govindji speak. Bhavna ji is here with us. Javed Saab is here with us. A lot of dignitaries here present today. The trustees, aapko bhi namaskar. Thank you for giving us this occasion to interact with students, parents, teachers, and a lot of people here in the audience. It's a very tall order to actually live up to the kind of things and the kind of you know enriching talks that Shyamji and after that Govindji have given us there were too many things that I wanted to say and too many things that I wanted to express but before I thought I would forget to say something I've noted everything down and I would like to talk to the students especially who I think is their first day. I just heard Somaditya say that's the first day of college and everyone remembers their first day of college. So I hope this occasion makes it really, you know, a treasured memory for all of you with taking back the lessons that you have heard from my seniors as well. I'm going to take back a lot of what I heard. I'm sure and I hope that it helps you ahead and you remember some of the things spoken by us today ahead in your life. I feel you students today are the youth of this country. You are the next, let's say, generation next. We have done our bit. We have come up till here where we have. Now we hand over this country to you to take ahead and take it ahead gallantly and magnificently. Is a request from all us seniors as we hand over the baton to you ahead, whether it is media or it is arts or it is anything. That you are passionate about. Okay. I thank also the Ompuri Foundation and the Har Kisan Mehta Institute for bestowing me this honor of delivering the first ever Ompuri Memorial Lecture. Ompuri ji is someone whom I've had the honor of working with personally, sitting with him, listening to his, you know, enriching stories throughout the years. That he has contributed in our film industry. When you think of Ompuri ji, you normally think of this, you know, very intense, deep, you know, angry young man kind of a projected roles that he did. The most memorable role that for me was actually very, very contrasted that showed the versatility of the actor that he was. One was Ardh Satya. How many of you have seen Ardh Satya? Excellent. And those who haven't seen it, it's a lesson to be learned. So watch it as something as a study on what an actor should be. And the second most memorable film of Omji that I enjoyed and I fell off the chair laughing was Jaane Bhi Do Yaaro. I mean, that is a classic. Who would ever forget the avatars, that different avatars that he played throughout being in the industry. You know, he was a wonderful human being and I'm lucky that I got a chance to work with him at such close quarters. That he was a legendary actor is not what I want to reinstate because we already know that. But I'll give you a very small incident. And that I think you should take it as a lesson in your life because there are a lot of senior students here. Some of you junior students will meet a lot of senior students as well. Thinking, you know, okay, so these guys are the cool ones. They are the seniors. And you probably get nervous also interacting with them. But that's exactly what happened to me. I did three films with him. An, Vinashak. And Ghat, I think. But Ghat, I didn't get too much to interact with him. And there are a couple of more films that are there in the list. But the magnanimity of the human being is not only that, oh, wow, he's so talented and an explosive talent at that. But how he is also as a human being. And that for me is very, very important as well. because in all aspects that makes you wholesomely successful as a person. You know, there was a time when I had to do a scene with him. I was very nervous, like really nervous, like you probably guys would be when you'll meet your students, you know, senior students and are made to debate or whatever the reason. So there was a scene that I had to do with him. And I was very nervous because in those days I was just kind of making a mark in movies myself. I was new, I was very young, and I got a chance to work with the likes of Nana Patekar ji, Naseer Saab, and Om ji. And, you know, I think sensed my nervousness. Now that's when the beautiful side of us comes out. There are many other superstars also whom I have worked with, but they would kind of let you be, you know, but not Om Puri ji. His first question before we started the scene was, nervous ho kya? Because I had a very long dialogue, and to look into his eyes and say that dialogue, not happening, people. So I was like, I said, Om ji, I'm a little nervous, you know, I mean, I'm working with you and I have to say this long dialogue, and all Om ji had to do was nod his head. So I said, this is not fair. They should have given you the long dialogue and made me nod my head. I'm so good at nodding my head. How many of you all have seen my songs? A lot of my hit songs. I'm only standing there and nodding my head. Yes, I was very good at nodding my head. So I told him, I said, you know, Puri ji, he said, arre chhod na scene ko, chal, idhar aake baith mere saath mein. So I went and sat next to him on the sofa. And then in his true Punjabi fashion, he started one joke and the other joke and the third joke. And soon both of us were rolling with laughter. And I forgot about all my nervousness, all my apprehensions, everything just withered away. That doesn't happen with everyone. There are times when I've actually worked with superstars who've gone out of the way to make me nervous so that they could steal the thunder from me. Yeah, that's true. But he was not that. He made sure that I was happy, comfortable, and the scene and the movie mattered to him. The fact that when a co-star gives an equally fantastic performance, you also shine automatically. So that was the greatest thing that you guys also should take ahead, is teamwork. Help your colleagues, help your co-stars, because ultimately all of you need to shine together. You know, and that was such a beautiful thing about him. And that's the lesson that I learned working with him for the first time. I'm told most of you here are... is it okay agar main apna chashma pehen lu, please? I'll still look nice, don't worry. Okay. Can I have my specs, please? Thank you. I just can't wear these lenses and all. Very uncomfortable. Yeah, this is not fair. I have so much. My first page is not over. Okay, I'll be fast, huh? Really fast. So, well, the reason that we were here today is I was told journalism, the topic that I was given, that I have to talk to a lot of you who are new, who are, you know, entering the field. And first day of college. Well, journalism is actually not like any other profession. It's known as the fourth pillar of democracy in India and across the world. Journalism is counted as one of the most important and powerful professions gone, because the power lies in your pen. You can make, you can break, you can unite, and you can divide. It's in your hands. As the saying goes, which Somaditya just stole from me, which I had already written down first, so I am saying it first, Somaditya. He has run away. That with great power comes great responsibility. But what should come easily to you is accountability and responsibility. You are accountable for the information that you'll be setting out to lakhs and lakhs of people ahead. Journalism is not all about sensationalism. It's not about retweets or Twitter or social media that, oh, I put this statement out first, you know, and that's why it has to get that many eyeballs, it has to get that many TRPs. Unfortunately, with media today, it's the race of eyeballs, TRPs, and who came out with it first. And the fact that today when you open a news channel, you open TV, everyone claims to be number one. How is that possible? Hamara channel sabse number one. सबको नंबर वन का अवार्ड मिल जाता है अलग अलग जगहों से तो सब समझते हैं हम नंबर वन है बट इन रियालिटी इट्स जर्नलिज्म इज ऑल अबाउट रिपोर्टिंग द ट्रूथ विथ रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी इट्स नॉट अबाउट यू नो दैट यू हैव गैदर्ड stuff and oh, I heard this and some facts that are given out should be with responsibility, thinking what the repercussions also can be. So that is where your responsibility comes. Don't get me wrong, as in criticism or talking truth to power is regarded as the hallmark of true journalism. But passing on misinformation or opinion or rumors as the truth is irresponsible journalism. You know, I will talk to you now as how I have been. I have not been a journalist. I'm not from the media side. But I have been at the receiving end. So for me, I feel that the key to journalism is, of course, that you have a desk, you have an output department, you reporters are the eyes and the ears of a news organization. You have to carry forward. But somewhere I feel in today's world, which you will be the future of journalism, is that do sometimes you just want to stand as a mute spectator to what is happening around you, or humanity comes to you first? I mean, we were talking about TRPs, and there was a time where a lot of channels would actually report with their camera person, with their crew standing over there, probably a woman getting beaten up. And they were standing there with their cameras, reporting the whole thing. Now at that time is when your moral compass should start kicking in. That am I here only to capture what is happening because I'm doing my job? But do not forget that you are a human being first. And there are times when you have to cross that line and not say, oh, I will only do this reporting because my news channel will get it first and then it will become a sensational thing. But what about you and your responsibilities as a human being first? There were so many incidents I remember where we would watch these on a lot of channels and say, okay, fine, this was happening. But what was the camera crew doing? While just standing there and watching, did they call out? Did they interrupt? Did they interfere before the woman got stabbed? Or were they just standing there and filming it and saying, I will get this news out first? So somewhere that balance between being a human being and being a journalist has to be done properly. Please remember, it is your responsibility as well. Do not lose that humanitarian emotion in you as a human being first. Always think of how and where people can be affected. Until and unless you don't have your facts right, please do not get carried away by this whole fake news, rumors, etc., which can absolutely go viral in today's day and harm more than help the betterment of society. So that is a great responsibility that you carry, the enrichment, the betterment of our society through you, because you will become the media. I can stand in a corner and shout all that I want, but only my four walls will hear. But who will take my voice across is you, the media, the journalists, the reporters. And then that, remember, is a very big responsibility for you. Because you are the medium that will reach out to the masses, to the people of this nation. So, you know, there's a lot of times where... can I get a hand mic, please? Is it possible to get a hand mic? You know, can I also have some of the lights on? I feel cornered in that corner. Yeah. Can I have some of the lights on, please? Yes, thank you. Can I also have some lights in the audience so that I like to see the people whom I'm talking to. It's too dark. Thank you so much. Hey, hi, I'm Ravina. Nice to see you all. This is better for me. You know, like I was coming to, you guys are students. You'll always see people who are on screen larger than life. But as a star, as an actor, or as someone who's constantly being written about, talked about, is also the viewpoint that I want to give you today. We are also human beings, but the kind of stuff and the kind of articles that we face sometimes also gives us a big question mark that, is this the same person they're talking about? The story, that the rumor that's just been floated, is that really me? it's not always like that. I'll give you a small example of how irresponsible media can be or has been. Very recently, first I'll talk to you about my 90s, what happened in the 90s. I went through this phase where I contracted brain fever. I was shooting in Delhi for a film called Bade Mia Chote Mia. And it was carried through a mosquito. And I remember another colleague of mine had also just got brain fever. And I flew down to Bombay. I was shooting for a film called Ghulam-e-Mustafa. And I started getting this intense headache which would not go by anything. I was shooting with Nana. And Nana Patikarji, and he also gave me some medicine. He said, you have this, you'll be better. But by lunchtime, my headache had become worse and worse. And there was a colleague of ours, Meena Iyerji, was there with me, spending the day, Bhavnaji was, who was spending the day with me. And she was doing a full a day in the life of an actor kind of an article for a magazine called Filmfare. So by afternoon, it started becoming really severe, my headache, and I was literally banging my head. And when I was walking on the street, I could feel the road like going concave and complex. And ultimately, they just told me that, you know, we'll pack up, you go see a doctor. I called my doctor, Dr. Agarwal, and I said, you know, this was happening to me. He said, come to Nanavati ASAP. And my back had started stiffening as well. So the pain was almost here traveling down my back. I reached Nanavati Hospital. They did lumbar punctures on me. I did an MRI because they said this kind of pain is only if you have a tumor in the head or a brain fever, which is meningitis. And they did the lumbar puncture, everything. They admitted me right away started mannitol. Mannitol is a medicine which is very strong, which goes to the brain. Started me on medicine immediately. My fever started rising and I was admitted to the hospital for 21 days till I was fine. My parents were informed, the doctors were there. Meena Iyerji in Filmfare that very month wrote about how I fell sick, how I was taken rushed to the hospital, and how they started my treatment, and I have brain fever, meningitis, and I'm not working now. So it became very big news. Another film magazine, the same month, same article, but what was getting them eyeballs and TRPs? That Raveena Tandon tried to commit suicide. So I went through this whole phase of literally 9 months after that. I mean, Dr. Agarwal was so crazy. Nanavati Hospital issued a statement. No, she has brain fever. These are her reports, everything. But who had caused sensation news? The other film magazine. And who sold better? Yeah, the gossip. So see, but you... what they don't understand at that time, they went away with it and I cursed them to hell. I did. I'm human. I was not magnanimous about it. I hated it. Because I had to go through nearly 1.5 years and till now, somewhere on the internet again that surfaces. She had tried committing suicide, but now they've changed the list of people whom I tried to commit suicide for. That list changes every article. So I'm like, okay, but last time they wrote that I tried to commit suicide for that person, but now it's for this person. Shit, okay, damn good, yeah, cool. So that keeps changing. So this is what we are talking about, irresponsible journalists. They don't understand what we go through or what the human being goes through by just creating this kind of news. Because for when I resumed shooting, all the other junior artists and everyone around me who are my co-workers, the dancers, etc., they said, ab aapki tabiyat theek hai na? Kyun aapne TIC-20 piya? क्यों ऐसे किया? And then be like, I had meningitis, मतलब के दिमाग की बुखार, because I couldn't explain to them what brain fever was. So it that is what happens, and you go through that whole thing, you know, of trying to constantly beat that rumor and trying to, you know, salvage of whatever's left of your reputation after that. So think about that also. Think about the human aspect of it. Secondly, just recently. Chalo, those were the 90s when once the headlines hit, you couldn't change it because there was no social media, there was no Twitter control, there was nothing that you could reach out to people and say, aisa nahi hua tha, bhai, aisa hua tha, this is the proof. Jo headline ek baar chhap gayi, wo chhap gayi. You had to deal with it. Clarification ya apology bhi aata tha, it would be the thin underline further, nobody will see. Matlab ye 10 chashme bhi lagao to dikha nahi. Khair, no problem. Now today's world, and today for people like you who are going to become journalists, is another lesson. A few days ago, a few months, I think a couple, just a month ago, You'll all know that the farmer dharna had happened, right? That the farmers were asking for their rights. Rightfully so, because I've always called them my annadatas. They are, our bread and butter reaches us because of them. And there was this whole dharna happening, and there was a lot of food being thrown and a lot of milk being poured on the roads and everything. And there was one article that I read in the Hindu newspaper where the president of the Farmers Association in Rajasthan said that hum peaceful dharna kar rahe the, some anti-social elements hijacked our protest and pure doodh ki tankiyan, jo milk transport hota hai jisme, khol ke kareeb 2 crore ka humara nuksan karaya hai. So it was not the farmers actually who had done that. And they had overturned all the milk, and those poor farmers in Rajasthan suffered 2 crore ka loss. Quoting that article, I put a tweet on it saying that these kind of people should be put into jail. I was talking about the anti-socials. Because I obviously thought someone who will read my tweet will read the whole article first and then will realize what I've said. That was not so. Headlines the next day from a very prominent regional paper said Ravina Tandon mante shetkari la jail madhe thevun. That I have said farmers ko jail mein dalo. Nowhere did I use the word farmers. Nowhere was I talking about the farmers. So that is again irresponsible journalism, because they did not even check to see what the article was. They said these people manje kai shetkari. And that for 2 days became the most sensational news. Till I tagged them, I called the editors. I'm one of those few lucky ones who has a great relationship with most of the editors and most of the people whom I interact with. And they realized their mistake, they apologized for it, and the next day clarifications were given. But by that time, the harm had been done. The kind of abusive trolling that I got after that was something that I will never forget in my life. So this is the repercussions also that can happen. So like when I say you have to do responsible tweeting, you have to realize what the person's trying to say first. The translation shouldn't go wrong. It should not affect people's life. The plus point of this whole controversy was that the next Times of India understood what I was trying to say, which in my follow-up tweets I had said that instead of wasting food and milk and vegetables on the road, go and give it to those needy poor people. We have villages in India where those poor children, malnourished children, with a lot of NGOs I work, I know on field work, don't even have a glass of milk in a day. They don't even get that. So my point was, don't give it to the government. You're fighting for your rights, fine, stand against the government. Don't give it to us. But instead, go and give it and do seva for those poor people who deserve it more instead of throwing it on the roads. And 2 days later, the presidents of Farmers Association and everyone, they sent me tweets saying, see, we're standing outside a hospital, municipal hospital, and they were distributing all their vegetables and this to the poor. So I'm glad that a positive outcome came out of it, ultimately. And Times of India then wrote a full article saying, at the actor's behest, the farmers have now started giving things to the poor. So, you know, somewhere along the line, you have to be responsible for your actions and for what you're going to do, because you can make or break a life. You can unite or you can divide. So it's a great responsibility, students. I wish you all the very best. This is your first day. I'm here, like I say, at a very special occasion with all my seniors sitting in front. All my respects to you and all my love to you. Thank you so much.
That is a very strong message you sent out to all those budding journalists out there. Okay, students, this is your lucky day. She has worked with Om Puri Ji in 3 films. So she fields just 3 questions. So please make that short and sweet. Would someone like to ask the first question? This is for the students, please. Yes.
First of all, a very good afternoon to everybody. And it's my absolute honor, ma'am, to talk to you. You're one of my favorite actresses.
Oh, sweet.
Okay, so my question to you is that today, as a young youth, what we observe in Bollywood films is that most of the you know, the 50-year-old actors, the 55-year-old actors still want to and are willing to play characters which are 25-year-old and 30-year-old. So, you know, and unlike the previous generation who aged with their film, you know, with their film characters, also with elegance, why isn't the probability strong with the current generation?
You know, I honestly think that if you'd asked me about maybe 7 years ago, I'd think that this question was relevant. But today, I feel when you see films, you know, the film that Aamir is doing, the films that now Salman is doing, the films that Ajay is doing, the films that Akshay is doing, they're all Anil. Yeah, Anil plays happily his own age. So I think it is great that our heroes and our actresses, I mean, Kajol is coming up with a film now where she's playing the mother of a college student, you know. So I think it's not that anymore. The awareness has absolutely come in and things have changed. But 7 years ago, yeah, I also used to crack a joke on this same thing. I don't know how many of you have seen Andaz Apna Apna. Yay! So I used to always crack a joke. I say, agar Andaz Apna Apna ka sequel banega, to picture ka first shot kaise shuru hoga? Shuru hoga, Karishma ji aur mera photo tanga hua hai deewar pe, Aamir aur Salman agarbatti aur haar chada rahe hain. Cut to, unki heroine kaun hai? 20-year-olds. Working with Alia and this thing, kyun? Woh unka to dhyan to gaya, chalo naye dhoondte hain. So, I used to actually make a joke out of it, but I am so happy to say that that is not the trend. The awareness has come, a lot is changing in the industry, great films are deservedly doing well, and I'm very, very hopeful for my industry.
Thank you so much.
Yeah, can we have a second question, please? Quickly. You don't see any hands raised? Yeah, okay.
Good evening, ma'am.
Good evening.
I wanted to ask, which political party do you support? And what is your prediction for 2019 elections?
You know, if I had started giving predictions, I'd not be here. I'd be some god man sitting somewhere making lots of money. So, I don't think I can predict. But yes, most definitely, your vote, thankfully in our constitution says it's a secret vote. So that I shall keep a secret. But the fact that what I believe in is to always give new governments a chance. You've tested and tried certain governments, and if they failed you, always try and give another government a chance. It's not that, oh, because I'm a fan and because I'm loyal to this one person, I will only keep voting for that party. No. See the party as a whole. It's not just that one individual. See the party as a whole. See what kind of work they are doing. And then take your call and definitely put that vote in, because you cannot constantly be getting manipulated and sold by the masses. To a certain extent, you are the one who can make the choice, and luckily our constitution gives us the right to kick out the government that we don't want, to retain the government that we want. It's all in our hands. So make that wise decision, check it out, and then put your vote in.
Very well said, Reena ji. Thank you. And the third and the final question, please.
Good afternoon, ma'am. First of all, I really want to mention how stunning you are looking.
Oh, thank you. That's kind of you.
So my question to you is, what do you think about the paparazzi culture in Bollywood? And do you avoid it?
You know, this paparazzi culture has come in very late into our industry. And let me tell you one thing. Luckily for us, in India, our culture, our roots, and the sense of respect is deeply ingrained into all of us since our upbringing. In the US, in Hollywood, or wherever, I don't think they even respect that line of privacy. But over here, if the photographers whom I meet on an everyday basis, and if I look at them, I go out with my children so many times, and I tell them, "Main aake photo deti thi, please bachon ka mat lena." They respect that, which I think I would give hats off to all the photographers in my country and my Bollywood colleagues who are in the media for respecting still that line of privacy. Thank you so much, everybody. It's been wonderful. Nandita ji, thank you so much for having me here. Govind ji, it was so nice to see you again. So thank you so much, everybody. Javed sahab, thank you.
Thank you so much, Reena ji. That was absolutely inspiring and exhilarating.